Welcome to Savvy IT Solutions. In this video, we are discussing about LCF ladder part 1. Okay, so in the previous video, we learned about nested if else with practically as well as the theoretically. In this video, we are learning about LCF ladder theoretically in 2 parts and practically in 4 parts. So total 6 parts to deal with LCF. Why? Because this is one of the important part in conditional control structures. So now we are discussing about LCF ladder. So the LCF ladder, before discussing about this, I informed that control structures, under the control structures, conditional control structure, under these conditional control structures, decision making or branching, under these simple if else nested if else and LCF ladder. Now we are discussing about LCF ladder. Okay, so when coming to the part of LCF ladder, in the previously we are learning about simply if else and nested if else directly, the syntax followed by the flowchart as well as the coding. But in this session, we need to know exactly where we are using LCF and what is the importance of LCF. It takes more time to explain. Later that we will discuss syntax followed by a flowchart and followed by 2 example programs in this video. In the next video, we will discuss 2 more examples to complete the LCF ladder. So here I am clearly explaining you why, because this is one of the powerful thing in control structures. Okay, so exactly where we are using LCF. The first question is, do you know how to calculate an electricity bill? Okay, so in the electricity bill, the bill will be generated based on number of units we used. Okay, but most of the people don't know how they are calculating it. So why? Because I am telling you, in the backside of the electricity bill, they are providing a table. The table indicates the how we are finding it. So in the backside of it, number of units, rate per unit and service charge. Okay, like this, they are providing 3 columns, and that is also differentiated from category 1, category 2, category 3. But here we are not discussing about categories. Why? Because if you go for deeper, the complexity of the thing will be increased. But one thing will be understand very clearly. In future, you can also understand easily how we are doing it. Okay, so the number of units are from 0 to 50. Okay, the rate per unit is 1.97 and the service charge is 5 rupees. Okay, the units from 51 to 100, 3.11, the service charge is 10. Okay, and the number of units are between 101 to 200. Okay, the 5.61 and 15. Okay, 201 to 300, 6.83, 20. Greater than 300, 9 rupees, and the service charge is 30 rupees. So let us take the values. What we are mentioned is not exactly correct, but it looks like this, and based on this we are extracting the information related to our program. Okay, so this is one part of the exam. And the second example is how we need to decide a student secured first class or second class or third class or distinction or failed. You know very well percentage and class obtained. In this, greater than equal to 85 distinction, in between 60 to 85 first class, in between 50 to 59, so it will write 84, 50 to 59 second class, so 40 to 49 third class, less than 40 fail. Based on this table, we need to decide whether a student secured first class or second class or third class or fail or distinction. So recent means past 5 to 6 years onwards, this concept is very trendy, very useful for the students, that the concept of CGPA or SGPA. CGPA means cumulative grade point average. SGPA means semester grade point average. How we are finding semester grade point average? Based on the below table, they are calculating SGPA. Okay, so the table consists of, so marks, grade points, so here greater than equal to 85, grade is O and the points are 10. In between 75 to 85, A 9. In between 65 to 75, B 8. In between 55 to 65, C 7. And in between 45 to 55, D 8. And the next one is 40 to 45, E 6 and 5. And less than 40, F, and the grade is 0. Based on this table, we are calculating SGPA. Here, in this section, means when we are discussing about LCF, we will explain about based on the mark how we are printing the grade. In the later videos, we will explain how to calculate SGPA with the help of the table. Okay, so the next last example is regarding roots of the quadratic equation. So quadratic equation is nothing but ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, where a not equal to 0. Only when if this condition is satisfied, then this expression will be quadratic equation. If a is equal to 0, then it is not a quadratic equation. So after that, we need to find discriminant or delta is equal to b square minus 4ac. If this d is equivalent to 0, roots are real and equal, and this discriminant is greater than 0, real and unequal, and this d is less than 0, imaginary roots. So now we are coming to the point that, so exactly where we are using LCF, the data, the input data is in the form of frequency. While calculating the input data is in the form of frequency, we need to use LCF ladder. So I think you understand, the data is in the form of frequency, definitely we need to use LCF. Okay. Now we are moving to discuss about the syntax. So if this condition is true, then statements 1 will be executed. Otherwise, again we need to check second condition. This condition 2 is true, then statements 2 will be executed. Otherwise, we need to check condition 3. If this is true, then statement 3 will be executed. This is false. Finally, somewhere it will continue checking, keep on checking it. Somewhere it ends. That end is the else, and the statement 4 will be executed. So that is the main concept of else if. Okay. So then now I will explain the syntax, means flowchart. So if condition 1 is true, here statements 1, no. So this is for s, this is for false. Again we need to check one more condition, that is condition 2, and statements 2, otherwise no. Again we need to check one more condition, statements 3, this is no, then statements 4. Okay, all are linked, and it will continue. This is the syntax, this is the flowchart for representation of else if ladder. Okay, now we are moving to the examples. We will explain two examples to you. One is electricity bill, and the second one is class obtained by a student. In this contest, we discussed these two things. In the next video, we will discuss about grade of a student, grade of a mark, grade of a subject marks, and second one is roots of the quadratic equation will be discussed in the next video. So regarding electricity bill, I need to take the table. Again, I am writing the table here. So I am not using service charge. Okay, number of units and rate per unit. Okay, this is a table, we are taking into it and we need to make it. So 0 to 50 we need to use, we need to take 9.1. so the costs are not at all rememberable, so by guessing it we are writing the numbers, so you can understand very easily. Okay, so 101 to 200 the rate is 4.97, and 201 to 300 6.17, greater than 300 9 rupees. So the values are randomly giving it. So now I am computing it. Before discussing about the code, I will write how we are calculating electricity bill. Let us assume the number of units are 350, then first 50 units into 1.91, and the next 50 units into 3.11, the next 100 units into 4.97, and the next 100 units into 6.17, and last 50 units into 9. So you will get some result. That result is the exact. Actually, people think that 350 into 9 will get some result. That is the output. But if you like calculate like this, the electricity bill will be very, very more. So that they are calculating in this sequence. Okay, for that purpose we are writing the code here. So now initially we need to check if units less than equal to 50, rate is equal to units into 1.91. Okay, else if units less than equal to 100, no need to check greater than 50. Okay, So automatically it checks, the mechanism itself checks it. Okay, rate is equal to 50 into 1.91 plus units minus 50 into 3.11. okay, again else if units less than equal to 200, so the rate is equal to 50 into 1.91 plus again one more 50 into 3.11 plus units minus this 50 plus this 50, 100 into 4.97. again else if units less than equal to 300, rate is equal to 50 into 1.91 plus 50 into 3.11 plus 100 into 4.97 plus units minus 100 plus 50, 150 plus 50 at 200, 200 into 6.17. okay, so finally we go for else, the rate is equal to 50 into 1.91 plus 50 into 3.11 plus 100 into 4.97 plus 100 into 6.17 plus units minus 300 into 9.00. this is the way we are calculating an electricity bill. Okay, now I am moving next program, that is write a C program to find the class obtained for a student. So simple, that I am also here also I am using the table, that percentage class obtained. So greater than equal to 85 distinction, in between 60 to 84 first class, in between 50 to 59 second class, 40 to 49 third, less than 40 fail. So based on this information, we need to calculate, we need to find the class obtained to a student. So here if percentage greater than equal to 85, so we need to printf distinction, else if PAs greater than equal to 60, printf first class, else if PA is greater than equal to 50, printf second class, else if PA is greater than 40, printf third class. Finally else we need to print fail. So this is the basic code for understanding it. So in the next video we will discuss about two examples. One is print the grade of a subject, grade obtained by the student for a particular subject. And the second one is roots of the quadratic equation. We will discuss roots of the quadratic equation. In this video, we discussed about where exactly we are using ELSIF and syntax followed by the flowchart. And we are understand two examples. One is finding the electricity bill, and second one is class obtained, to find the class obtained for a student. Okay, thank you.